it is that time of year again, a time when we set out to become a better version of ourselves and to take those concrete steps to try to live and feel better. But how can we stick to these steps to be better, a better version of ourselves? This morning we're joined by Dr. George Moritz from the Naples Center for Functional Medicine, giving us a little more on how functional medicine could be the key to stick to some of those resolutions. Good morning. Thank you for being here.
Good morning. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. So many of us are looking to maybe make a change, a subtle or in some cases drastic change in this new year to not only feel better but look better. And it sounds like you're the guy we need to talk to.
Well, you're right. The most common question I get is, how can I be healthier, wealthier, and sexier in the new year?
Right.
And in the time we have today, maybe we can answer some of that.
Okay. We'll take it. What is the difference? You talk about functional versus basically applicable medicine. What's the difference between
Sure. So traditional medicine finds ways of trying to immediately get you better. Mm-hmm. And while we don't want to say it band-aids the symptoms, root cause medicine, which is functional medicine, mm-hmm. goes to the root cause. In other words, more detective work.
Okay.
And some of that could be lack of nutrients or mm-hmm. toxicity, too much of another thing.
Ah, okay. And so if you're a different age group, it depends on kind of what you need. We were just speaking about that. You know, somebody in their 20s might not need what somebody in their 50s does.
No, that's a great point. So what is the difference between anti-aging medicine mm-hmm. and functional medicine? So when you're 20, it doesn't matter if you sleep right, eat right, you wake up the next day.
Right.
You're a dynamo.
You're still looking young.
You yeah. essentially have a perfect roadmap or a blueprint of youth. Mm-hmm. So if you get sick, you could go root cause. You could go to the reason why you were sick. But you have all these natural youthful chemicals running your body.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's compared to, let's say, you're 50 plus.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're no longer as youthful. Things don't recover as quickly.
Right.
So not only do you have to go to the root cause of why you're sick, but you also have to rewind you back to that perfect roadmap, what I call your youthful blueprint.
Ah.
And most medical problems really aren't medical problems when you do that in anti-aging medicine.
So what is the first step that you normally take when clients come in or patients come in to you and ask for basically the fountain of youth?
Well, it's a really good question. First of all, goals, because everybody has goals, and then we have to be realistic about those goals. And then there's a deep assessment, you know, everything from lifestyle factors, illnesses that people have gone through,
mm-hmm.
and then you do some testing,
sure.
some very in-depth testing. So when you combine those two things, then you can roadmap someone and basically line up over a course of the year. Because for someone who's serious about becoming youthful, mm-hmm. freeing themselves of chronic disease, you want to dedicate some time. And so you want to evaluate that kind of a relationship so it works out in the course of a year.
And you're not talking about the normal physical that so many of us have, you know, checks the cholesterol, height, weight, that sort of thing. This is more in depth.
You're right. So some things in medicine are outdated. If you read it in a textbook or saw it on Google, it may not be the most up to date. What we're talking about is very in-depth testing,
mm-hmm.
not just things in your blood, but actually in your tissues.
Oh, wow.
Also looking at measurements in the body that we don't look at. Traditionally, when you go to the doctor, you look at temperature, height, blood pressure, weight.
Sure.
But your fifth vital sign is body fat. And how many of our viewers actually know what their body fat is?
Their actual number, right.
Because fat is your largest hormonal organ.
Sure.
It spews out all these chemicals. It's probably one of the reasons for why people got COVID, why mm-hmm. people get high blood pressure and cancer. So we look at things like, for example, like body fat,
mm-hmm.
and then we do more in-depth analysis, everything from evaluating a nutritional depletion to toxins, looking at hormones, and then from that you can create a nice picture of what youth might look like, free of disease.
And then that's where you go for your diagnosis and your treatment plan, I would assume.
Exactly.
As well.
It's all individualized and customized, mm-hmm. and that's what's so enjoyable about this.
It's got to be interesting, a puzzle to solve, if you will. I know that we were talking about during the commercial there about sleep, and I know that a lot of us hear about sleep, you got to get sleep. Even people who say that they're getting enough may not be getting the type of sleep they need.
So what you've correctly described, Jen, is restorative sleep, you know,
okay.
usefully restorative sleep. Most people say, I sleep this long.
Right.
But in reality, they don't wake up refreshed. And in another argument, disruption of sleep, which starts in what's called the pineal gland. We have this little gland in the brain that looks like a little pineapple. And when you disrupt it, that's what causes a lot of disease. Everything from your thymus gland, which has T cells, your thyroid, even cancer.
Wow.
So if you want to disrupt someone's body, cause metabolic issues, give them heart attacks, strokes, and stress, what you do is you sleep deprive them.
Wow. And how can you get better sleep? I mean, what? How do you advise your patients to go down that path?
Sure. So the generic things are sleep hygiene. We want to know, you know, what are the habits that lead you to sleep? Mm-hmm. But for many people, they actually have some hormonal and peptide disruption in their brain. Ah. So it's not exactly their fault. So we remove the things like alcohol. Mm-hmm. We remove flickering lights. We try to do things that remove the disruption of getting to sleep. But then for some people, there's things that happen why they don't release, go into deep sleep at night. And that's really what we're talking about, is getting them into youthful sleep.
So that's one thing that we could all do, at least try at home. Is there something else that maybe our viewers can try now before they would come to see you?
Well, years ago, I put together a sleep guide, which we could make available for our viewers.
That'd be great.
When they get on our, when they can call Naples Center for Functional Medicine, mm-hmm. it's my From Beauty Sleep to Sleeping Beauty. I wrote that guide years ago.
That's great.
I was a sleep sufferer, like 70 million other people mm-hmm. are right now. I was a OBGYN by training. Mm-hmm. I delivered babies night and day, mm-hmm. and I disrupted my sleep.
So you had no set schedule.
I kept meeting people who also had, you know, a form of, I would call a jet lag or disruption in their circadian rhythm. Mm-hmm. And so I went from being an expert in hormones to actually looking at sleep.
Wow.
So I started looking at the sleep chemistry, designed some systems to help that. And so that's the most common reason people come see me, is saying, look, I realize maybe all my problems may be related in some way to sleep.
Wow. So treat the problem and not just put a Band-Aid on it.
Exactly. And then all the other problems may not be as difficult.
I love that. How can we get in touch with you? I'm sure people would love to learn
more.
Sure.
So we'll have the number up on the screen, mm-hmm. Naples Center for Functional Medicine. Mm-hmm. And we would love to have someone inquire and find out. We also have a live event coming up on the 12th. Mm-hmm. Which we'll be hosting, and people will come and we'll take topics, interesting things like we're talking about today, and expand on them.
That sounds really, really cool. And that's just open to the public?
They do need to register.
Okay.
Make sure they register. And once they do, we'll get them on the schedule, and they'll get all the information.
Thank you so much, Dr. Moritz. We really, really appreciate your expertise. And again, you see the information right there, how you can not only get in touch with the office itself, but that event coming up on the 12th. We sure appreciate your expertise.
Appreciate
time is 9:29. We're going to be right back with more in the morning.